each other proportionally, then it is a trapezium. Now here, one quadrilateral is given, we have to prove that that is a trapezium. So if it is a trapezium, we have to prove that one opposite pair of side, means one pair of opposite side is parallel to each other, right? So it is sufficient to show that one pair of opposite side is parallel to each other, right? So we will draw for the figure.
CE by EA equals to DE by EB. means DE by EB equals to C by EA. So from this given we can write what is the DE by EB. So here we can replace, right? So DE by EB equals to C by EA. So we write here CE by EA equals to DF by FA. Here what is the reason? This is second statement. But what is the reason? From given we can write, right? So from this given we have done this, right? Now here we got the second statement CE by EA. Where is the CE by EA? CE by EA equals to DF by FA. DF by FA. So where this ratio we got here? So in this triangle, which triangle? In triangle ACB, we got this ratio CE by EA equals to DF by FA, right? So when this ratio we got, or when this ratio we will get, then we can say that this line EF is a parallel to DC, correct? So we will write here from this in triangle, which triangle? ACD. In triangle ACD, what we got here? CE by EA. CE by EA equals to DF by FA. DF by FA. CE by EA equals to DF by FA. Then we can say that EF is a parallel to DC by converse of BPT, correct? So hence we can write what? EF is a parallel to DC. Okay? By converse of BPT or Thevenin, right? So but here we got EF is a parallel to DC. But here EF is a parallel to AB. We have drawn here EF is a parallel to BA, right? So but here we can write what? EF is a parallel to BA, right? Now you can see these two statements. These two statements. EF is a parallel to DC. And what we have given already, we have right here construction EF is a parallel to BA, right? So from these two statements we can say that DC is a parallel to BA. Yes, of course. So we can write, hence we can write DC is a parallel to BA, right? And then DC is a parallel to BA, or DC is a parallel to AB. So it means that DC is a parallel to AB. So it means that when DC is a parallel to AB, it means that ABCD is a trapezium, right? Here we got one pair of opposite side is parallel to each other. So when we have to prove ABCD is the trapezium, here only sufficient to show that AB is a parallel to DC, correct? So hence we can write ABCD is a trapezium.